know it's interesting. I was sitting back here, listening to this theme music along with you tonight, wondering just how many thousands of times I've activated the equipment, cued in the theme, opened the mics, and then just verbally shared with an audience. I don't know, but one thing that I do realize, perhaps along with you, is that there's got to be more than just what we've been into today, or are doing now, or plan to do tomorrow. We're conditioned to know more. We're built for eternity. And I welcome you to Night Sounds. In fact, as we look back at creation, Adam and Eve, our first father and mother, begat Cain and Abel. And when Adam and Eve were driven out of the Garden of Eden, their first offspring knew pain that they didn't know when they began. And you and I feel it tonight. Ever wonder about Cain and Abel, the first children of Adam and Eve? How they must have felt, and what Adam and Eve must have thought when they looked at their children and wondered just what kind of a world they were being born into. Tonight, we're going to consider, as the subtitle of our time together, Cain and Abel. For the next few minutes, let's go back in our mind's eye to those first days of creation and the dichotomy, the friction that took place as sin entered the world, the anger, the jealousy that began to pervade mankind in those days. Let's listen in on Cain and Abel.
Abel, is that you?
Cain. Hello, brother. I've just come to make offerings to the God of our Father.
As have I. Are you still killing your animals for offerings?
There is something, Cain. I'm not sure what, but there is something set apart in this God's mind about blood.
Yes. You said that before, and Father seems to think you're right. I think you've been out wandering the hills too much alone.
Alone in the hills with my animals. There's much time to think there.
Crazy thoughts.
No, Cain. There are times when the God of our Father speaks to me.
You see how crazy?
How can you say that? Don't you believe?
I don't know what I believe.
Then why do you bring sacrifices? Why do you bring the first fruits of your fields?
It makes Father happy, and if there is anything to it...
Oh, I would be afraid to approach our Father's God in that way.
You're a crazy wanderer. Settle down. Fight the earth for a while. Make you more sensible.
I must make my sacrifice.
Here, you put my fruits and vegetables with your... your bloody mess.
No! Cain, look!
Your sacrifice has been burned up.
And yours just sits there, untouched.
What trick is this?
Trick?
Well, what is it? Yours is accepted and mine isn't? Is that it?
It may not be the sacrifice that is not accepted.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you said yourself you weren't even sure you believe.
So what are you saying, little brother? That you are accepted and I'm not?
I don't know what I'm saying. I just... Perhaps if you were alone for a while, you'd understand.
What? Where are you going?
To talk with Mother and Father before I go back to the flocks.
You'll be sure to tell them what happened here. Self-righteous little...
Why are you angry, Cain? You don't need to be angry. You could be happy if you do what's right. But if you don't, watch out. Sin is waiting to attack you, to destroy you. You must master it.
Must you go so soon, Abel?
I'm afraid my flocks care little for my family ties, Mother.
You're doing well with them, Abel. I'm proud of you.
I'll go with you a ways, Abel.
Oh?
There's something I'd like to talk with you about.
You wanted to talk about something?
I want to show you something. It's just up around this next clump of trees.
What is it?
Oh, you'll see. You'll see.
Thank you.
just up around this next clump of trees.
What is it?
You'll see.
I really don't have much longer, Cain. My flocks
are... Your flocks can...
Can what?
I'm afraid, little brother, that your flocks will have to find a new shepherd for a while.
Cain, what are you...
What? It's so...
So quiet.
No birds.
No nothing.
Well, groan or cry or something. He isn't breathing. Abel! Abel! This is enough. I'm sorry I hit you. Abel! He is lifeless. Without life.
Death?
I've brought death to him. No one must know. I must hide him. But where? In these bushes. No, he'll be found. Yes, I must dig. I'll hide him in the ground. No one must know. They must all think he's gone back to his flocks. I must hurry. Now, as far from this place as I can get, no one must...
Cain!
Huh? Who's...
Where is your brother?
Where are you hiding? Why can I not see you when you talk to me?
Where is Abel?
I... How should I know? Am I supposed to be his keeper or something?
Your brother's blood calls to me from the ground.
His blood?
What have you done?
I didn't mean...
The ground has opened its mouth and received your brother's blood. It will no longer give its strength to you.
It will no longer...
You are banished, Cain. Banished from this ground you have defiled. You will wander all your days. You will be a fugitive and a wanderer.
But where will I go?
It doesn't matter. You will call no place home again. You will call no man friend or brother again. You have killed.
But I didn't mean to...
You did what you meant to do. Your hatred has set you apart. Thus it is, and thus it will always be.
And that, in the minds of those who represented that depiction, was the way it happened. Cain and Abel set a pattern. What is the hunch but the voice of God's Spirit in our own unconscious mind warning or guiding us? We have not learned the simple act of listening, but we can learn. And if there comes to us a word of warning within us, it would be the better part of wisdom to obey it. God spoke in an audible voice in those days in the Old Testament. And with Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, he confronted them every night as their friend, their creator. They looked forward to seeing him. But after disobedience, that beautiful creation was marred. And now his creation is a threat. He is a threat to those who don't know him. But he has allowed himself to be known tonight. You and I are very different from all other created beings. We have the voice within us. We might even call it a hunch or intuition, but it's not blind. We have minds to think and wills to choose. In the account, you remember that God accepted Abel's offering, but didn't accept Cain's. Maybe that seems unfair. Cain, feeling a sense of guilt or dissatisfaction within himself, thought to win God's favor by offering some of his crops on an altar, burning them up with fire. And Cain, in his dissatisfaction with himself, hated his brother, who was more spiritual than he was, and he killed him. And he didn't repent. The voice of God asked him, "Where is Abel?" The voice of God may be sounding inside of you or me right now in a still, small impression. It did Cain no good to deny, because there was a witness to this murder, the earth itself. And he told Cain, "When you till the ground, it won't yield anything. You will be a fugitive and a vagabond upon the earth." And so it was. So the earth itself rejected Cain. But man was not allowed to kill him. That would have increased upon the earth the curse of bloodshed and violence. So God put a mark on him, so that all men should see and know that although sinning, he still belonged to God. As we think of the account of Cain and Abel tonight, there is a very definite prototype, a representative of human behavior from that day to right now. Even with you and me, when we feel ourselves inferior or are in some way dissatisfied with ourselves, instead of recognizing our faults, our lacks, and coping with them, we often project our dissatisfaction with ourselves on someone else. It's the other guy. It's blame fixing. We blame our environment, our parents, our teachers, those who have influenced us, those whom we trusted. And instead of digging out the evil in ourselves, we try to destroy it in someone else. But we can't kill evil by killing a person or people, because that evil clings to the very earth whereon we live, and there it breeds more evil. And as we look back in history, it proves this. Shakespeare said, "The evil that men do lives after them." Words don't die, their rage continues. It almost sounds futile. And often on Night Sounds, we begin with a negative, a condition that most of us would recognize. And I would not dare to close any program without bringing in an overtone, an overview of the positive. But thinking about the condition of brokenness and evil and murder and wickedness that lies within the human heart, if it just stayed there and there were no rays of hope, I certainly wouldn't get on the air. I'd be in the entertainment business and try to get our minds off of it.
The children play reluctantly. They seem to sense the change. For this happy home that they once knew, they will have to rearrange. With thoughts of being secondhand, and no one seems to understand, you are left with love that's smashed upon the rock. Comes the voice of the one who bore the shame of this mistake. I will never leave you, Jesus said, and I never will forsake. He knows your grief, he feels your pain, he has been forsaken too, and he can heal the deepest hurt inside you, the happy ever after that once filled your hopes and dreams can turn into reality. Though all is lost, it seems your love
of Johnny Ho, Love Smashed Upon the Rocks. And that's exactly what happened from the Garden of Eden on, through Cain and Abel. These two latter are subjects of tonight. And this is Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce, with you by radio. Each night we come to you with a little different approach, and tonight it's a dramatic one, more vividly portraying what happened back there. However, something wonderful occurred 2,000 years ago. Into the midst of this cacophony of human suffering, the Redeemer stepped upon this earth and gave us hope. The Redeemer Jesus Christ, in whose name we gather tonight, not to be religious or unreal or, well, borderline or abstract, but to recognize once again that this is our only hope. Jesus was no wishful thinker. He wasn't a cheerleader saying, just think of the positive side, guys, you'll be okay. He knew the cost of sin. And it meant death to him and resurrection. So the resurrection is the key word. That's why we have hope tonight. Jesus rose from the dead. And the scriptures say it is appointed unto man once to die. And the Lord Jesus is the only one who came back from this out-of-body experience to say, hey, I am the resurrection and the life. Believe in me, though you are dead, and you shall live in spite of it all. That's the message tonight. And it's a matter of faith and yielding and placing your entire weight upon this word. Something inside you confirms and tells you that this is true. It's not my word. I'm no prophet. I'm just a guy in communication. But he's touched my life, even though I don't sense him all the time. There is no other hope, no matter what you might come up with. So again, this is why we're on the air with a glad message of salvation through the Lord Jesus Christ, who can touch your life, your heart, and your destiny, and your business, your talents, the people with whom you deal day by day, and make a difference by forgiveness, by letting you know that there is something positive ahead for you. We come on the air every night with a message like this. And it's really meant to be a dialogue. I'd love to hear from you. If we can help you in any way beyond our program that we're able, this is our desire. Sort of the Night Sounds treasury of recorded music. Just standing with you, listening to you, praying with you, being a friend, sending materials. Let us know who you are and how we can help you. Our mailing address, Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. You'll find our email address at nightsoundsradio, that's one word, at AOL.com. And join us on our website. That address is nightsoundsradio.org. So what are you thinking tonight? The book of Proverbs in the Old Testament reads, "As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he." You know, if somebody convinces us that we don't look well today, we begin to feel like this. If we think that we're evil or bad or inferior, we begin to take on the characteristics. The world is sick, and maybe you are too, individually, in your heart. But Jesus came, and he's here right now by his Spirit. And he taught us to pray, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven." Cain could not take away the stain of his brother's blood from the ground, but in Jesus, God himself came to earth and shed his blood willingly to take away the poison of condemnation from this earth. And again, Jesus didn't say, "Cheer up. This is the best of all possible worlds." He told us truly of great tribulation to come. But through this, we'll be preserved. And he saw the kingdom of heaven. So tonight, let's lift up our heads, because he's here. He's always been here. In fact, there's a song written about this. I want you to listen to it now, if you will. He was there all the time. We thank you that even though Cain and Abel represented the beginning of murder, and that, of course, represented all sorts of sin in our hearts and lives and in humanity that followed age after age, we recognize the very fact that Jesus came to say to us, "I am come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly." Thank you for this. There are many right now lifting up hearts and hands for deliverance and salvation and healing. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you will touch that one with hope who reaches out to you right now. Amen. I appreciate so much the privilege of coming your way night by night with the program Night Sounds. As I said a few moments ago, I'm just one person who happens to be on the air late at night, after dark, to bring to many a lonely soul hope and comfort, to let you know that you are significant, you are valued, you are important. Jesus thought enough of this truth to die for you. And that's what our program is all about, just to remind you that you are loved. But you're not a machine. He wants your allegiance and your heart and your life. Would you reach out right now in your own way and ask him to enter your life and yield your life to him? If you would allow us to be a part of this, let us know. We'd like to pray for you and send materials that will help along the way. What a privilege it is to be a part of this kind of outreach. Think about that now, and what we've said tonight and what we've heard for these moments. What a beautiful privilege it is to live and move and have our beings, and a lot of the kinds of things that we're into in a day we take for granted. Someone said what we take for granted, we seldom take seriously. Let's take God seriously. Let's take that urgency within ourselves that there's something more to life than just living and existing. Taking it seriously, so be it. Thank you for listening and sharing. Our mailing address once again, Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. Until we meet again, a good day to you tomorrow, and good night.